Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So this time you guys are in my living room, and as you can tell, I'm going to be sharing about this. So if you saw the title, you kind of know what it's about, but I added two more things and I'm going to give you my personal examples that you can apply. And you guys had asked me about more law of attraction videos, so I thought, why not share about this notebook? But I'm going to show you two other things that I incorporated. So I'll give you my personal examples in case you guys also want to try that. And without talking anymore, let's begin. So I had this notebook a while ago, and if I'm not mistaken, I bought this from the Dollar Tree for $1, and I had this for so long. And I remember buying this because the front, it's kind of 3D and it has kind of like fabric, and I thought that was really unique. And for a long time I didn't know what to do with it until I thought that I should use this as my abundance notebook and put it to good use. One book that I read earlier this year about the law of attraction is Becoming Supernatural by Dr. Joe Dispenza, and this is how it looks like. This is kind of a long book. It was 14 hours and 6 minutes to listen to, but most of the time I would put it in faster speed at 1.25. But I recommend you actually get the book if you can buy it or check it out from the library, because it has a lot of graphics. I tried to find it at my local library, but they didn't have it. And basically, if you like The Secret, you're going to like this even more, because this goes into the scientific evidence on how the law of attraction really works. So they go into the whole science. It shows you how it's connected to the brain. Like, they do all these brain scans. And so they just go really deep into showing evidence on how it really works. So if you like The Secret, you're gonna like this so much more. I like this even more. So I highly recommend it. So you are able to attract anything that you want in your life. And it talks about specific examples on how it helped many people. My abundance notebook. So as the title refers, this is just for me to keep track and to be grateful of the things that I receive. So I'm gonna give you my examples to give you an idea. And so basically it's like saying a thank you to the universe for everything that you attract into your life. So I got a lovely purse from one of my friends in Guatemala. My mom recently came back, and it's a beautiful purse, so I feel grateful for that. I also received a lot of strawberries from my mom's aunt, so I feel grateful for that. I got that over the weekend. And last week I was invited to a Mediterranean restaurant to say goodbye to one of my ex-co-workers at my previous job. I couldn't make it, but I gave thanks. So those are three examples as to just feel grateful for anything. It could be the smallest thing, even if you find something, even if you find a nickel on the ground, it could be anything, and just give thanks. Or even for being alive today, or for having a home, for having a car, whatever it is, and just feel grateful and write it down so you can attract more of that. Okay, there's a second thing that I started to incorporate in my abundance notebook. And that is that I also write down the things that I wanted to attract in my life. So these are specific things that I asked for. Okay, so I had asked for 1,000 likes on an Instagram photo. And this was last year when I made my travel to Guatemala. So what ended up happening is that two big accounts reposted my photos and they received 1,000 likes. On another occasion, I had asked the universe for clothes. I just simply asked for clothes, and a few days later, I was contacted by Amazon and they sent me money for me to spend on clothes. And that happened, I think, on 3 or 4 occasions, and I shared those outfits with you guys on another video and on my photos on Instagram. So that's something that I was able to attract. I had also asked the universe to appear in any type of movie, commercial, or music video. And if you guys know about me, I took acting classes for 1 year. And so what ended up happening is that this girl, she was looking for people to be part of her filming project at UM. And so I was part of that film. So I appear in a small section of that project that she did. So that was really cool. And one last example, so I don't get you guys bored, I was attracting a new job that was near me with free parking and the pay that I had in mind. And so that happened a few weeks ago. The job is so near me, it's in my car. I can get there between 5 and 10 minutes. Free parking, which is awesome in Miami, because in some jobs either they offer parking or they don't. Especially in downtown Miami, you would have to pay for parking a lot of the time, and the cost of living in Miami, it's already expensive, so it doesn't really make sense to be working and also be paying for parking. And they're gonna be paying me what I had in mind, so that's really awesome as well. And by the way, just ignore this section on my chest right before filming. It was so itchy and I scratched myself. And the last thing that I started incorporating in my abundance notebook are intuitions. So anything that I think about and it comes true, kind of like in the Twilight movie, I'm forgetting her name, but the vampire with the short hair, where she thinks about something, she has a vision in her head and then it comes true. Well, that's basically, I have intuitions really regularly. And again, so I'll give you some examples. Okay, so this one time I was in my car and it was kind of late. And I don't know how, I forgot to turn on the lights. And I immediately thought, turn on the lights because a police car is about to pass by. I turn on my lights and literally seconds after, a police car passed by. So that was like, wow, what I thought about, that happened. So that's cool. I really like it when that happens, when I kind of know, I get a glimpse of the future. This was at my previous job. We had recently hired this lady that we really liked and I was giving her training. But over the weekend, like, I knew on Monday she was just gonna come and say that she just was going to leave, that she was going to quit. Like, I knew it. Monday comes and that happened. Exactly what I thought about, that happened. She came in and really politely, and she felt bad about it. And she said, let me just be honest, I'd rather not work. She had a personal reason why she couldn't stay. But like, I knew it. Like, the minute she told us, like, I already knew it. It didn't surprise me at all. And another intuition that I had is with an Instagrammer. And like, I knew she was going to announce she was pregnant. Like, I knew it. And a few days later, she literally announced that she was pregnant. And like, I knew it. Like, I had thought about it and it happened. So those are a few of the intuitions that I've had. And I like it when it happens because it's kind of like, I know what's going to happen. And now that I remember, years ago, this was even before I had my daughter, I think in 2007, I'm forgetting, that big tsunami that happened in Asia. I think that night, or like a few nights before, I dreamt about the tsunami, like this big disaster. And I remember it was in December and we were in Guatemala and we overheard the news in the radio. So yeah, that was like, wow. Like, I didn't even think, you know, like, you have dreams and you think it's just a dream, it's not gonna happen. It was such a long time ago, but I dreamt it and it happened. Well, and that's it. That concludes my abundance notebook. I hope you guys have liked this video. You guys had requested more of these type of videos about law of attraction. And don't forget the book that I told you guys about in the beginning. It's going to be in the description box in case you guys want to check it out. And I'm curious to know about your stories too. What have you been able to attract into your life using the law of attraction? You can let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And you can follow me on all social media pages with the same name, Lynn Sire. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Kisses. Bye.